Guess who we got to star in Legends? Joan Collins and Linda Evans. Of course they get along. That's them now.
Are you talking to Linda? Find out if she's still in show business.
Is that Joan? Find out if she's still alive.
Ladies, you're on conference call.
Joan?
Linda?
Darling!
I thought you were dead.
Legends, the comedy about big stars and bigger egos.
Darling, I thought you were dead. So, where's Mr. What's-his-name?
Clemmer, Martin Clemmer. He phoned as I was going out the door. He'll be along in a little while.
My, my, my. What a ravishing cape.
And don't you look simply marvelous?
If it was any longer, I could mop up the floors with it. Aretha, better watch out for your job. Come here. Give us a kiss.
Oh, why not? No biting.
Picture!
No, only from above. Get up on a chair or something.
Yes, I only like to be photographed from my left side.
Thank you!
This left over from the party.
Darling, I'm not, because we both won an Oscar. Me for playing a hooker, you for playing a nun. Say that last speech of yours for me. Go on.
Oh, yes, I love that last speech.
You can laugh and bray all you want. You can call me a bride of Christ, but you can't take away my...
No. Not the nun thing. The one from Rainbow's End.
I don't remember it.
Of course you do. You remember every line you ever said. And everybody else's, too.
All right, I remember it, but I won't say it.
Oh, I just love that movie. It was so sad. You know, I cried so till my sinuses threw in the towel.
This little shriek.
But you know what? I think that's why I became an actress. I I'll become a famous movie star, and then my real parents will come forward and claim me. But they never did. Maybe I'm still waiting.
Didn't that really upset
I'm
you?
Getting it.
Now, come on, let's pull ourselves together if we can. Oh, and remember, this is an acting exercise. Don't act normal. Act stoned.
You must be...
Martin Clemmer, producer of the off-Broadway hit, Crack.
Oh, well, let me get your coat.
Oh, thank you. No, I'll keep the briefcase.
Well, right this way, Martin Clemmer, producer of the off-Broadway.
Go to sleep in an empty cold water flat with a lit cigarette in my hand. I mean, I want to be cremated, but I don't want to do it myself.
Or just get old and shriveled up.
Yeah, like Gloria Swanson. She just got tinier and tinier and tinier and tinier. And towards the end, she could run under a coffee table with a picture of her.
In the name of Loretta H. Young, are the two of you going on about? Just take the bait and run with it. Now, you all, you got enough energy to tear up this whole apartment. You need to get up on that stage and tear it up. Take that negative energy, turn it into something positive, and make something good happen.
Sylvia, let's do the play.
Oh, thank you, Lord, for bringing it to our senses.
We'd be doing what we know how to do. No, what we love to do.
Yeah, we'll give them the fun now. It's the roller coaster, the parachute ride. We'll give them a show they'll never forget.
We'll give them our charisma.
We'll give them our feud. They'll remember that.
And if they don't, we'll remind them.
Ooh, you should, because folks love to get in on that shit.
You know, Sylvia, after spending an evening with you and surviving, I think there's actually a very sweet person way deep down inside of you absolutely screaming to get out. Mm. And I think your public would love to see that person.
Well, thank you, dear.
What if we really surprise them and switch roles? You could play the goody-goody for a change.
I would get that big crying scene, and then when you threw all the acid in my face, I'd get all the audiences in. No. No, the bitchy one's got a lot more to say.
Remember, sweetheart, what Bougie Watson said. There are no small parts, only small actors. Mm. However, if we did switch, I'd have to play the bitch for the first time in my life. Mm. I wonder if I could do it.
Darling, I've just spent an evening with you two. I know you could do it.
But I'd have to read lines, well, like this.